You may find yourself living in your garden shack, and you may find yourself not at home in your home, and you may find yourself looking for your large automobile, and you may find yourself without a beautiful house, without a beautiful wife, and you may ask yourself, well, how did I get here? Same as it ever was. Same as it ever was. Same as it ever was. Same as it ever was.
لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك
إن الحمد
إن الحمد
والنعمة
والنعمة
لك والملك
لك والملك.
Welcome to the higher check.
I need you shiny and bright here, Alan. Look, we both know the only reason you got this job is your connection to the king's nephew. You're in charge of a deal that's pivotal for the company, which makes it even more pivotal for you. But you got more questions than answers here, and that makes me uncomfortable.
There are unanswered questions here because I haven't been to Saudi yet. I can't presume to know the lay of the land or the state of the king's mind.
You've been on the bench for a while, Alan.
This isn't the Schwinn days. You're not selling bicycles to kids anymore.
So I need to know that you're on point, that you're going to close this.
This is sales. You make estimates, and you make plans. But then you get there, and everything changes. But you make the sale.
I'm sorry. I got in really late last night, and I forgot to set the alarm.
Don't worry. We're just getting set up. Hold on. You guys know how Alan can get a ride out here?
Maybe you should rent a car.
Can you rent a car, Alan?
I'll figure it out.
Front desk.
This is Alan Clay. Who am I speaking with?
My name is Edward, sir.
Edward. Where are you from, Edward?
Jakarta, Indonesia, sir.
Jakarta? Indonesia. Edward, what would you think of me renting a car through the hotel?
Do you have an international driver's license?
No, I don't.
No, I don't think it would be possible to do this.
Well, could I hire a car and a driver then?
Where to?
The King's Metropolis of Economy and Trade.
This is my little house. I'm going to get a car.
Morning.
Excuse me. Are you Alan Clay?
You the driver?
Driver, guide, hero, Yusuf.
Oh, no, no, no. I'm not the chauffeur. Get in the front.
It's the water, Philly.
You sure this thing will get us there?
I drive this thing to Riyadh all the time. It never fails me. Just one second.
So everything's okay?
Oh yeah, no, I just had to disconnect the engine before I came into the lobby.
Why?
Well, to make sure no one wires it.
You mean hot wires it to steal it?
No, I mean wiring it to explode. No, no, it's not a terroristic.
It's just this guy who thinks I'm screwing his wife. He might be trying to kill me. Here we go.
So, I'm in a car that might explode?
Oh, no, 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 no. It's nothing to worry about, you know? I don't think he knows how to wire a car that way. He's not a tough guy, he's just rich. It would only be possible if he hired someone. If you were this rich guy, you would hire someone to wire the car of the man screwing your wife,
yes?
Fuck. Now you got me scared.
Anyway, Alan, where are you from?
Boston.
Boston. Yeah. I've been to Alabama. 1 year of college.
You studied in Alabama?
Yeah.
Why Alabama?
You mean because I was the only Arab for 1,000 miles? I had a scholarship for 1 year in Birmingham.
Birmingham?
Yeah.
Oh, I like Birmingham.
Are you hungry? You want something to eat?
You mean like stop at a restaurant? We just got in the car.
I could go to a place in the old city.
No, I'm in a hurry, remember?
You're late. No, they didn't tell me you were late. And we should be going this way if you're late. Do you like Chicago?
Not in the winter.
No.
The band.
Oh.
You know our love was meant to be. Kind of love to last forever.
How long is the drive?
To Kemet.
And what? I want you
the King's Metropolis of Economy and Trade. We call it Kemet.
Yes, to Kemet.
Is that where we're going?
From tonight until the end.
Just kidding. It's about an hour. You what time are you supposed to be there?
8:30.
Be there at noon.
Always on my mind.
Anyone to mint?
In my heart, oh. In my soul. Baby, you're the meaning in my life. You're the
you know what? I don't like Chicago.
Oh. You bring feeling okay. To my life. You're
let's see what else we have on here, huh? Why are you going to Kemet?
Work.
Ah, you're in construction.
No, I'm in IT.
Ah, IT. But you know there's nothing happening there.
No, not yet.
Oh, not ever.
I've done my due diligence. I'm presenting out there. It's full steam ahead.
Okay. See for yourself. Look, they're sweeping sand in the desert.
I'm guessing these aren't union men.
No, we don't have unions here. We have Filipinos.
Expecting you. I'm Saeed.
Saeed.
Salaam alaikum. Sorry to hear that you missed the shuttle. I understand the hotel had some trouble waking you.
Sorry, I'm late.
The king won't be coming today, so your tardiness is inconsequential.
Is my Relian team somewhere in here?
No, they're in the presentation area. Follow me. Some juice?
Oh, thank you.
So, Mr. Clay, allow me to conjure our Majesty's dream. This is where we are right now. And this is the city in the year 2025, hosting a minimum of 1.5 million.
Port is there. Industrial city. University. Business center. Life and Leisure Park.
Very impressive.
خلاص روح. أنا ههتم فيه.
I have to go. Here. In case you sleep in again.
Full steam ahead.
We'll see you at 3, over there in the main building. As for Karim Al-Ahmed, he's your primary contact.
My team is in there?
Yes.
In a tent?
Yes. I trust you'll find everything inside.
Roth.
Howdy.
There he is. Hey, Kaylee, Brad, Alan. Good to see you, Rachel.
Welcome.
So, how are you guys doing in here?
Fine, but we can't get a Wi-Fi signal.
Except for a faint one from that big pagoda. I mean the office building.
Have you asked anyone about it?
We figured we'd wait for you.
We've been trying to email Karim, our contact.
Karim Al-Ahmed, I have a meeting with him at 3. Oh.
That's great.
Which is soon. Yeah. That's not gonna work.
But what if the king arrives today?
He won't. I was told he wouldn't.
Oh, good.
And you've met him before?
The king? No. No. I just met his nephew. And that was years ago.
Was he a prince?
Yeah. Yes, he was. And he still is.
What do you call a fish with no eye?
I don't know.
Anyway, look, the king is not coming today, so you guys can just relax.
Shouldn't we call corporate and let him know the conditions here are untenable?
No, Brad, we should wait until I talk to Karim Al-Ahmed at 3 o'clock.
Do you know why we're not in that building?
Well, maybe all the vendors are in here. And maybe we're just the first.
Kind of weird being Reliant and being out here.
It's a brand new city. It's uncharted territory, and we are the trailblazers.
Where are we supposed to eat?
Guys, come on! We are in the kingdom of Saudi Arabia, with the deserts and the camels and the sheiks and the tents.
Oh! Oh my God! Oh. Are you okay?
Yeah. Don't you know they can only kill me with a golden bullet? Golden bullet, you know. You get it? It's Lawrence of Arabia.
Who?
Hello there.
Hello.
What is your name?
My name is Maha.
Maha. Great. Where are you from?
My name is Alan Clay. I'm with Aurelian Group. I have an appointment at 3 o'clock to speak to Mr. Karim El Akma.
I'm sorry to say he's stuck in Jeddah. He won't be able to make it today.
He's stuck in Jeddah?
Yes, sir. But he said he'll be here tomorrow all day, and you can name the time you want to meet.
Oh, okay. But I'm with the Aurelian Group, and we are out in that tent down there. And we can't get a good Wi-Fi signal, which is essential to our presentation.
I think Mr. Ahmed will be the one to speak to about this. He's in charge of the vendors in the tent.
Understood.
And any time tomorrow will be fine. It will all get sorted, I'm sure.
Okay. Thank you, Maha.
You don't know how to pay for college? Sell the house. How long does it take to sell this fucking house?
Ruby, I can't change the real estate.
Bullshit! Just sell it, for Christ's sakes. And then pay for your daughter's education. College is your thing.
Welcome to the Hyatt Jeddah.
Good night, guys. See you in the morning. Hello.
Hi, Alan. I've got Eric Randall for you.
Okay, great.
What do you mean he didn't show up?
Well, he got stuck in Jeddah. It's tomorrow now. But we'll be fine, I'm sure.
Okay, but don't forget to call me first thing after that meeting.
I've got Mike Winston on the other line.
Oh, put him through.
Hey, Dad. I hope your trip is going well. Is it hot over there? A little dusty? That's a joke. I'm a joker. Everything is fine here. Not totally fine. Mom called last night and wanted to do what she always wants to do. Blame you for everything. But I'm fine missing a semester or two of college.
I'm so sorry, Kitty.
It's actually doing me good.
Dad, it's okay. I mean, I can use the break to rack up some extra tip money. I mean, I'm good at this.
Yeah, but don't get used to it. You're going to college.
Listen, Dad, I trust you. Don't listen to Mom. She said, what's he doing in the desert? His problems are here. I told her that you know what you're doing. And then she gets on me for taking your side. She says I'm like you. Can't see the big picture, lacking ambition, the usual bullshit. Maybe just prove her wrong, Dad. Prove her wrong.
Front desk?
This is Alan Clay. Is it possible for me to get a beer or something?
I'm sorry, sir, but consuming alcohol is strictly prohibited in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia.
Ah, yes, of course. How about a Diet Coke?
Diet Pepsi?
Sure. Okay, thanks. Hey, Dad. It's Alan.
Alan, you sound like you're on the moon.
No, I'm in Saudi Arabia.
What are you doing in Saudi Arabia?
Well, it's actually pretty interesting, Dad. I'm here with Reliant, and we're pitching a new IT system to the king. We have this remarkable teleconferencing equipment, and we're presenting it to the king himself. It's a three-dimensional holographic meeting.
You know what I'm watching on TV here, Alan?
No, what are you watching?
I'm watching this thing on how a gigantic bridge in Oakland, California is being built in China. Can you imagine that? They're building the goddamn bridges.
I gotta say, Alan, when you took Schwinn over there to China and sacked 900 of our homeland people, I could see the rest of it coming. Makes sense if you're
some shit-ass, bloodthirsty executive hellbent on hollowing out the economy for his own gain.
Nature of the beast. But the bridges, I did not see coming. Oh,
Dad, you're breaking up. Are you there? Are you there, Dad? You're breaking up.
Oh, damn it. Oh, God damn it.
I missed my shuttle again.
Oh, well, that's my day off. Just kidding. I'm available.
How long do you need?
17 minutes.
Make it 23.
You were waiting in the lobby for what, 5 minutes? What kind of bomb could anyone install in 5 minutes?
Well, how would I know? I watch the same TV shows as you.
Ready?
Oh, don't make it more dramatic.
Hey, you like Electric Light Orchestra?
Yeah.
The city streets are empty now. The lights don't shine no more. And so the songs are way down low.
Hey, that's the mosque I see from my balcony. There was something going on there yesterday, a lot of people.
Yeah, that's where they do the executions.
You mean outside? Publicly?
Yes. You want to go back and check out what's going on now?
No. No. Never mind.
Oh, the dollar.
Good morning. Do we have good Wi-Fi?
Nope.
All right. Hello. What's happening?
Excuse me?
Is Mr. Kareem Malikmat in?
I'm afraid he's not. He's in Riyadh today.
You assured me he would be in all day.
I know, but his plans changed last night. I'm so sorry.
Let me ask you something, Maha. Are you sure there isn't someone I can talk to about our presentation to the king?
I'm afraid not. Miss Al Ahmed really is your primary contact. He'll be back tomorrow. He guaranteed it. Excuse me. Iwa naam. Hasalak bas dagiga. I'm sorry.
You look new.
Oh, hi. I'm supposed to meet somebody.
Are you Alan Clay?
I am, indeed.
Hello, my name is Hannah. I work for Karim. He's not going to be in today, so he told me to look out for you.
Well, it's nice to meet you, Hannah. Where are you from?
I was just about to have a smoke. Join me? Order?
Please.
No, we live like teenagers here.
Hiding our vices from that shadowy army of parents.
Oh, oh my God! Oh. Are you okay?
I'm fine.
Sure?
Yes.
Ah, that's...
I'm having a squabble with the chairs in this kingdom.
Sit with me.
Yeah.
This is better.
So you're from Relian?
Recently, yeah. We hope to supply the city with its IT, but I'm trying to get an idea of the timeline of when the king will come in.
I hope they didn't make any promise to you.
Well, no, not really, but I was led to believe our process would be, you know, fast-tracked.
Wow, that would be really good for all of us. The king hasn't been here in a while.
How long is a while?
Well, I've been here 18 months and he hasn't been here yet.
So how's the jet lag? Have you adjusted?
Actually, I feel like a pane of glass that needs to be shattered.
Oh. You've got pills?
No. No. Figured I'd be executed at customs.
I have something for you.
You have good Wi-Fi here?
Sometimes, yeah. But you know, Wi-Fi is the least of our problems. There you go.
Olive oil.
That's what you tell anyone who asks. Just have a little taste when you get back to the hotel. I'm pretty sure it will shatter your glass.
Okay, team, here's what I got. One, no update yet on the food. Two, and I quote, Wi-Fi is the least of our problems. And three, the king is coming, just nobody knows when.
That's all Mr. Al-Akhmad told you?
I didn't meet with him. I will tomorrow, hopefully.
So, should we set up today?
Yes. Unpack the rest of the gear. Check that we're ready for showtime. I think we should expect the unexpected. This is Alan.
I've got Eric Randall for you.
So did you meet the guy? Kareem, what's his name?
No, but I met his associate. Very nice woman from Denmark.
From Denmark? And?
Really encouraging. We should be ready to roll by tomorrow afternoon, I think.
Welcome to the Hayat Jeddah.
You mean the king is coming tomorrow?
Hi, Alan.
Probably not tomorrow, but she said Mr. Al-Akhmad will confirm specifics very soon.
What is that supposed to mean? Alan, half the board is calling me just about every 20 minutes.
Steve Milligan is on the line.
Jesus, you have to give me something more exciting.
Okay. Dear Kit, you say that your mother has always been emotionally unreliable. That's true to a certain extent. But who among us is completely stable all the time? Dear Kit, from this godforsaken hotel room 5,000 miles away, I offer you this confession and ask you for your forgiveness. I've made your short life one of burden and worry when you should have been living carefree. My penance for blowing it is my being here, a salesman back going door to door, with my own burden being this mini hump on my back, which is either a disease about to eat my spine,
Dad,
or a sack of spiders growing under my skin.
Dad!
Your mother would be pleased either way.
Stop this, please.
Stop smoking, Kitty. So, forgive me for not being the father you deserve, for not providing you with a means to follow your dreams. All I can do now, and for who knows how long, is hope an opening comes along. That I can somehow squeeze through and make things right.
You available?
Alan, you sound terrible. Were you run over by a camel?
Can you take me to Kamat?
Of course. Are you missing your shuttles on purpose to spend more time with Yusuf, your guide and hero?
You are using too many words.
Hey, do you like reggae?
So where'd you get the booze, huh?
Excuse me?
I know a hangover when I see one. Where'd you get it?
I would rather not say.
What, you think you might endanger your source?
Oh, you think that's funny.
I do, yeah. But listen, you really don't need to go to Kemet today. There's no way the king is coming. He's in Yemen.
Right here.
Yeah, it's not too far.
Where are we going?
Well, you said you wanted to try real Arabic food.
I didn't say that.
You'll do great, I promise. It's the best hangover cure in town. Come on.
At least I won't let my ticket, Jamal. Isma, Habib. مشغول دحين. خليني أكلمك بعد. يلا, bye. That was her.
Who?
The woman I shouldn't be talking to. Jamila's her name. Gorgeous girl. Very beautiful, you know? Hayakal. But unfortunately, not very smart.
Sweet. But dumb as a goat. Anyway, she's married to this older guy. This older man is very rich, but also a little strange.
Strange?
I think he's some kind of international swinger.
What does that mean?
I think he goes to Europe and has sex with boys.
Oh, so he's gay.
Gay? No. You think that means he's gay? Anyway, a few weeks ago, she started sending me these texts. At first, they were just bored, like, what are you doing, blah, blah. But recently, they've gotten, like, really sexy. If he had seen any of those messages, I'd be dead. She'd definitely be dead.
So she is jeopardizing her life for these texts?
أهلين حبيبتي. أيوة أيوة وصلتني. بتحب أغني لك هي؟ حبيبي
ازعل نص نص.
مشتاق لك والله. ماشي أوكي. Her again.
Why do you talk to her like that?
What do you mean?
Oh, that lovey-dovey way. It's like she is your girlfriend.
Because she's a sweetie, you know?
You need to sit down with him.
What?
No.
You need to sit down with him, and you got to look him in the eye, and you have to tell him that you haven't done anything with his wife, because you haven't, right?
No, nothing. Never.
So you tell him this. But this is how he knows you're telling the truth. You look him in the eye, because if you actually were screwing his wife, you'd never face him.
Mm-mm.
Trust me. This is how you handle this.
Alan, you're back. What is that?
No, I removed the scab. Is it bad?
You want to see a doctor?
Alan, where are you? Why are you not out there?
Because nothing is happening today.
Why not?
The king is in Yemen.
Shit. And where are you?
I'm at the doctor's.
Are you sick?
No, it's nothing. Don't worry. I'll be fine. Don't worry.
Okay, all right. But don't forget...
I think I have to go now. Talk to you in the morning. Bye, Eric.
Mr. Clay?
Yes.
I'm Dr. Hakim. Come inside. Did you do something to it?
I did a bit of investigating.
With what?
A steak knife.
Was this an attempt on your life?
No.
Are you on medication, Prozac? Or...
I'm not depressed. I was curious. I was just trying to see if...
You have a minor infection.
What is it, that thing?
I suspect it's just a lipoma.
And that's not bad?
Well, if it's a lipoma, then it's just a growth, like a cyst.
So it's...
benign.
Are you sure?
No, to be sure, we'd need to do a little bit more investigating.
It just said it's so close to the spine, and I haven't been well recently.
Not well?
Clumsy,
slow, lacking energy.
Can you specify?
I don't know. I've lost direction, I think. And strength and certain abilities. And
for instance?
Well, I've always been pretty good at creating simplicity. Making complicated things and situations go smoother, easier.
So your feeling is that this bump is the cause of the loss of those capabilities?
And that's unlikely, is it?
I would say it's unlikely. We should do a biopsy to make sure.
A biopsy?
Yes, and then we send it to the lab.
Great.
Says you're really worried, huh?
Oh, I'm worried about a lot of things.
Okay, you can change now. I had the same thing a few years ago, like a tightening in my chest. When I got the EKG, I was so sure I'd find out I had a murmur or an irregular rhythm or something that would explain the fatigue.
And?
Was nothing.
That's too bad.
We're stuck with our stupid good health. So come back on Sunday and we'll take a look at the results, okay?
Sunday?
Our weekends are Friday and Saturday.
Oh, right. Will you be here on Sunday?
Yes. I'll see you then, Mr. Clay.
Thank you.
A woman doctor, huh? Where was she from?
I don't know.
But you're a Saudi?
Yeah, I think so. Why?
Well, we don't have many women doctors, so, you know. Odds are against you running into one at first opportunity. Was she veiled?
Yeah, a hijab.
And you saw her alone? Interesting. Yeah, so, what time tomorrow?
Shut up.
Welcome to the Hyatt Jet.
This is Alan.
Hey, it's Hannah.
Good, how are you?
I didn't ask you how you are.
I guess I felt you should know.
Okay. Are you already in bed?
No. Why?
There's a party at the embassy tonight.
At the Danish embassy? Soren Kierkegaard.
City?
Copenhagen.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. Oh. You seem to have a plan. I admire that.
What? This is how much I excite you?
I'm sorry, you're gorgeous. But I can't help but be distracted by the fact that I'm a little drunk. Mm-hmm. And I'm on the floor of the Danish ambassador's cloakroom with a beautiful woman I don't really know.
Mm. Mm. Would you take offense if I tried something else?
I wouldn't take offense, but I prefer if you didn't.
So this is frustrating.
Yeah.
What do you think we should do instead, then?
Would you like to hear a really good joke?
Hey, you like Elvis Presley?
No! No! What? What? Yes. Yeah, just not now.
You know, your sleeping schedule is really beginning to worry me.
Oh, I had a really weird night last night.
Yeah, why? What the hell?
I can't talk about it.
Why not?
Because I promise not to.
Oh. Okay. Of course. Yeah. Huh.
What has happened?
Hey, are you all right?
Yeah.
What happened to the AC?
It just stopped working.
I've been asleep about an hour. Sorry.
Any chance of the king showing up today?
No, he's in Riyadh today.
All right, you know what? You know what? I've had enough. I am going to go up there, and I am going to come back with some answers about the AC and the food and the Wi-Fi and at least some semblance of a timeline.
Whoa. Alan, where's all this bluster coming from?
I don't know, Rachel. But I promise to utilize it to everyone's advantage. Good morning.
Hello.
Hello, Maha, how are you? Is Kareem Alakmad in today?
I'm afraid he's not.
And will he be in today?
I don't think so. He's in New York.
New York? What about Hannah?
Hannah?
Danish girl, works in payroll.
I don't...
I'll be all right. Thank you, Maha.
Excuse me. Can I help you?
I'm looking for Hannah, the Danish consultant.
I'm ready to see some customer. I'm afraid she's in Riyadh today. Can I help?
Alan Clay. I'm with the Relian Group.
Kareem El Ahmad.
Kareem El Ahmad. You're not in New York.
No, I'm not. My apologies, Mr. Clay, but I have to leave for a meeting and I'm already late. Why don't you join me and we can discuss a few things along the way?
Where to?
To that area of construction where the condos are being built. I'm meeting one of the architects.
Your receptionist said you were out today.
I'm sorry, she's new.
Were you here the last 2 days?
No.
Nice.
Would you like to drive?
Oh, no, no, no.
Ah, please, be my guest. I assure you, no other vendor is more important to us than the Relian Group.
Well, that's very good to hear. But there are issues.
Tell me.
We cannot set up our presentation out there.
Why not?
Because we are in a tent.
I'm sorry, but that's the designated presentation.
We need a hard line.
I cannot do that.
We need very good Wi-Fi, at least.
I will have it fixed. What else?
The air conditioning doesn't work. My team is suffering.
It will be addressed immediately. What else?
How do we eat? We've been bringing food from the hotel.
After the weekend, you will have catered meals every day. Anything else?
How long will we be waiting for the king?
Turn left here.
Is it days?
I do not know.
Weeks?
I don't know.
Months?
I hope not.
Wow.
I can see you must be driving a sports car yourself. In the U.S.?
No. It's an executive privilege thing. We used to have private races down in Texas.
When you were with Schwinn?
Yes.
I owned a Schwinn bike as a kid.
You did?
Yeah. I lived in New Jersey for about 5 years. And then later in business school, Schwinn was one of our case studies.
Hmm.
Interesting period. This way. Schwinns were made in the U.S., the rallies in England, the Italian bikes, the French. For a time, you had real international competition. You're choosing between very different products with different heritages, sensibilities, techniques even.
Well, that's gone now.
What happened, in your view?
I thought you studied our case.
I did. Schwinn went to China.
We did. They could build our bikes a lot cheaper and a lot faster, and it seemed like a good idea at the time.
But it wasn't.
Well, obviously not. We taught them how to build a really good, solid bicycle, and they took that wisdom and started making all the bikes themselves.
And now they own the market.
Well, it's because they can sell them for nothing. But it's just a matter of taking different stickers and putting them on the very same bikes. Just built in the same factory somewhere in Asia, all the brands there are, and now Schwinn is just one of them.
Do you ever feel you might have done it differently?
Me personally?
Well, you were on the board of Schwinn when all that happened, no? Do you think there might have been a way for the company to survive? In America, I mean.
It was complicated.
Do you know that some of our people are already living here?
Really?
Yeah. You should take a look at one of the units.
Me? Why?
You'll be spending some time implementing the IT plan, no?
Well, yeah. If you get the job, yeah.
Excuse me. Hello. Aywa, mean mine?
Huh.
Hey, lahza shwi. This is going to take a few minutes. Go ahead. It's on the fifth floor. The elevators don't work just yet. Take the stairs. It's not a long way up. Ring the doorbell at 501. There's a man, Hassan, he'll show you everything. I'll be with you shortly. Aywa, hawalni. Ya hala, Abu Abdurrahman.
Clay, I presume?
Hassan?
Very good to meet you. Come in.
Karim Al-Ahmed called me. He apologizes. He had to leave.
He ditched me?
I don't know. I was told to give you a ride. Tea? Or something more compelling?
Would you have a cold beer?
Of course.
Oh, Thank you.
You're welcome.
So you actually live here?
No, this is the sales room. I have a separate space upstairs.
So, how's business?
Honestly, quite trying.
Oh, it's too bad.
We're not getting any firm commitments from anyone.
Well, what about those restaurants you're promoting downstairs? When do they open?
That's a bluff. We haven't sold any spot to these companies.
Yusuf, I think
Alan?
I'm having a stroke.
Mr. Clay?
Okay.
Don't sleep. Look at me. Have you been drinking? Speak to me. You'll be okay.
Down, Martha. Intika, my love. Ruhi na midahin. Tus bahia lacher, habibi.
As I said, you're stuck with your stupid good health.
Are you kidding? What happened to me? I couldn't breathe. This was scary.
I think it was the scare that triggered the whole thing.
Well, how do you mean?
Those symptoms are usually indicators of what we call an anxiety attack, which often leads to a physical breakdown, and what with your jet lag and... I'm sure this didn't help.
Am I going to jail?
No. Nobody saw it, I think.
You did?
Yes.
Aren't you obliged to report that I'm in possession of illicit beverages?
No. But I don't think you should drink this stuff. It's bad for you. We have better booze in Jeddah.
I have a question.
Yes.
What are you doing here?
You called me.
I did?
Yes, I was on a late shift. I had just finished an operation.
Thank you.
Alan! Alan!
Yusuf.
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum salam.
Oh, God. I called you, too.
Yeah, you worried me.
I'm sorry. Yusuf, this is Dr. Hakim.
Hey, Solo.
Alhamdulillah, mafishi. Ya hasti jalu sakta galbiya, bas rabana satar.
Oh, thank God.
Do you get some rest and try to relax over the weekend?
Thank you. I will.
What's going on?
What do you mean?
What's this Saudi woman doing here with you in the middle of the night?
Well, she's my doctor.
You know, that's absurd, no? You and the Saudi woman doctor.
What are you talking about?
She might be married. For sure she has kids.
Yusuf?
But there's a lot at stake for a woman like her.
Yusuf! Stop it! What is wrong with you? I'm not having an affair with my doctor.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Are you okay?
I heard some noises outside my house. I got out of bed. I saw three men standing at the window. And
nearly crap my pants.
The husband?
And his henchmen, yes. They just stood there. That was it. I have to leave town.
Leave? Where to?
Up to my father's place in the mountains. They won't go there. It's my home village. Everyone there will look out for me. We have guns and all that. I'm sorry about what I said before.
How long is the drive?
Did I crash it, Majid?
Not bad.
It's my nephew, Salim. He's coming too. My nephew said.
Salam.
He's the grandson of my father's second wife.
What are you?
I'm the third son of his third. My father has four wives. Welcome to the KSA.
I forgot about that.
Sorry. You know who.
Hey, what does that mean, exit non-Muslims?
Yusuf.
Yes.
Yusuf, what are you doing?
What? Oh, shit.
What's going on?
I missed the exit back then.
Hey, look for it.
The last exit you found.
What are you doing?
Stop it. What's happening?
You're not allowed to enter Mecca. It's holy ground. It's for Muslims only.
What?
But I forgot. You know, it's a routine. I always go this way.
Yusuf, billah, khud lak ay makhraj min al-bar hina.
Sajidni, Allah yasajjak. Kus umm as-sa'a li jibtak ba'aya fiha. And when it gets smuggled to the holy city? Wallahi al-azim. We can put you in a thawb. You'll pass. If we get stopped, just quote your favorite verse from the Quran.
So that's the famous mosque, huh?
The Haram, yes. Actually, would you mind not looking at it?
Oh, sure. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Oh, shit.
What does that mean when you do that? Point up like that?
It means God will provide.
And that works?
It ends the discussion.
Cops. Thank you.
Salam.
Salam.
You need a ride?
No, no, thank you. I'm just out for a walk.
Taking some pictures.
Yeah, it's a beautiful place.
I was watching you from above. You take a lot of pictures.
Yeah, I guess.
American?
Yeah.
All these pictures. Do you work for CIA or something?
Just a little freelancer work, nothing full time.
You've been kidnapped.
No, it's just so beautiful, I just kept exploring. Hey, what's with these rifles?
Well, I wanted to show you, actually. This one belonged to my grandfather.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah.
See,
I thought you'd know something about rifles.
I used to be a decent marksman in my time.
So tonight, you want to hunt some wolves with us?
Wolves?
Yeah.
Where? Here?
Yeah, apparently there's some wolves skinning sheep lately, and they're organizing a hunt, looking for anyone who can shoot.
Hunt! Yachi, manza!
Min wain jayt ant?
Qaad yilflifina wnaak, yisawwa raihi!
Dakhil bayti, ma'alli sawtak
tada! Yilflifina wnaak, yisawwa raihi! Sab li qaad sawulna!
Ish al-mushkila?
Hu li qaad li! Ish qaad li? Huwa shaghal ma'al mukhabarat al-amerikiyya!
You tell this guy you were with the CIA?
Oh, he asked me if I worked for the CIA. I said I just did some part-time freelance work for them.
Why would you say this?
Well, it was a joke. I was joking. He asked me, it was a ludicrous question.
It's not ludicrous to him. Now I have to convince him you're not with the CIA. How do I do this?
Well, look, if I was from the CIA, I wouldn't go tell the first person who asked me.
Mash, salli al-Nabi, ya Sheikh. Salli al-Nabi.
Allahumma salli al-Nabi.
Mash. Hada khawiyya min Amerika, dhaif.
Khawiyya.
Khawiyya. Dhaif. Shake his hand.
What?
Shake his hand. Shake his hand. Amerika yubyamzah. Iza kan bil mukhabarat, ma rah yqul lak innahu mukhabarat.
Mzah.
You shouldn't have said that.
I know.
People don't like jokes like that.
I knew it as soon as I said it.
It's like joking that you have a bomb when you're in airport security. It's.
That's the analogy I had in mind, yeah.
Let's go hunting, huh? That's where the sheep was taken last. Were you ever in the army?
No. My dad was.
Where?
He volunteered in Korea.
But you didn't want to join the army.
Me? No.
Why not? No good wars?
Exactly.
That's you would have fought in World War II?
I would have gone. I would have tried to avoid the Pacific.
And if you're young now?
You said, why all these questions? Are you thinking of joining the army?
Maybe.
No. Don't.
Why? Why not?
No, you should go to college and finish and give yourself some options.
There are no options here, Alan. You know that.
Well, then, leave.
I prefer to stay here and have things be different.
It's nothing. It's just the sheep. Hey, Alan.
Would you fight for us?
Fight for you? How?
No one's going to invade Saudi Arabia.
No, no, I know. I'm just curious, just about individuals.
Probably. I think we have a lot of people who are willing to fight to support people who want to be free, and Americans love a cause.
So if I start a democratic revolution here, you would support me?
Oh, is this your plan?
No, I'm just asking. Would you?
Of course.
How?
Well, I don't know.
You would send troops?
Me personally?
No. You know what I mean. The U.S.
Send troops? Not a chance.
Air support?
Nope.
Shock and awe?
Here? No way.
What about personally? Would you personally come to support me?
Yeah.
That was quick.
Well, I'm sure.
You're crazy. I'll be back.
You'll wait here for me?
طيب ما في مشكلة.
So you wait, right?
ما في مشكلة.
Mr. Clay?
Yes.
Come in. Please.
I'm confused. Am I not meeting Dr. Hakim?
No, she's not in today.
But I've got these results here from your biopsy.
Please, have a seat.
Now, we found some precancerous cells below.
Precancerous?
Yes. You should have it removed.
Well, have what removed?
Your lipoma. The whole thing, and the sooner the better. We can do it here. It's not a big deal.
When would that be?
How about tomorrow?
Sit on the side. Quiz? Booker? Sit down on the side. Quiz?
Hi.
What are you doing here?
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Sorry.
You do?
Did you resort to bribery or coercion?
We've got a great solid signal.
The food is amazing.
We've been trying to reach you.
I was out of town.
Well, whatever you did, it worked.
You're the man, Alan.
So, are we ready?
One sec. Hey, Dave.
Hey, Brad. How's it going?
Sorry.
Gotcha.
Me too. It's a bit low res, but...
Let me adjust this.
It's getting there.
There you are. Show me your movement ratio.
That should be your pretty face.
Yep.
And this is my hideout.
Got it.
Let's check projection stability with our favorite object. Nice and easy.
So, is it really happening today?
Your Royal Highness, distinguished members of the royal family. For centuries, business has been done in the same manner as friendships have been made, with culture and language separated by the mere distance of a handshake. In Boston, Massachusetts, your friends at Relian have developed a new technology for virtual encountering on a global scale. Allow us to give you a demonstration.
Hey, Alan. Cheers.
Sticks and stone can break my bones, but holograms can never hurt me.
Work, Alan. Very nice. Now let's keep fingers crossed they don't choke on our budget.
Thrills galore.
Yeah, and we'll know soon.
Well, maybe we should celebrate that. Do you need a ride?
I think I should stay with my team.
Yeah. Okay.
You the anesthesia man?
Hello, Mr. Clay. How are you today?
I'm fine, thanks.
Good. This is Dr. Wei from China and his assistant. They'll support me with the procedure.
Dr. Wei from China. Hi.
Let's do the marks here. Antiseptic.
نسمعك دكتور حداد افضل لو اني اكمل العمليه
لكن بدينا زي ما انت شايفه
لسه ما بديت ولا لا
والله ما لي فاهم لكن على العموم
Hello Mr. Clay
Hello Dr. Hakim
I'm sorry I couldn't be here on time
I didn't think I would see you again
I'm taking over now the anesthetic should already work is that warm enough
Yes Thank you.
Scalpel. I will talk you through the entire operation, but it might be more comfortable for you to think of something completely different. A good person, a nice memory, or something you look forward to.
All right.
I will approach the affected area now with a small cut adjacent to the lesion. Now that I've made the necessary incisions, you might feel some tugging as I extract the cyst. Here it is.
Dear Dr. Hakim, I hope this message finds you well. Your skill made quick work of that cyst, so I want to thank you again. I've been feeling increasingly energized since the operation, and I've already been able to transfer that energy to others successfully. The only catch is, now I don't have anything to blame my problems on. That little growth explained everything, and now it's gone. I am sincerely grateful, though, I think. Alan Clay.
Dear Mr. Clay, even though it went a little harder than I expected, it was a simple extraction. Usually the discovery that you're not dying of a malignant tumor leaves most people with their spirits high. But you are not most people, are you? Dr. Zara Hakim.
Dear Dr. Hakim, actually my spirits are very high, indeed. Maybe too high. I'm feeling a little dizzy. The cause is mysterious, but I have felt a strange new lump in my back. I'm no doctor, but it feels like a rubber glove. Is there a chance you left one? Sometimes people leave things like gloves with someone they like in hopes their retrieval will provide an excuse to see that someone again. Yours, Alan.
Dear Alan, I actually might have left something. I'm thinking a sponge, or maybe part of a snack I ate during the surgery. I think I need to see you again. Perhaps out of the hospital. I don't want to worry your insurers. Zara.
Dear Zara, that's a very good idea. But to tell you the truth, I have no idea how this is done in the KSA. I mean, Mr. Alan Clay meeting Dr. Zara Hakim outside of the hospital. And I hope it doesn't appear too inappropriate to ask you for advice.
I'll pick you up on Wednesday. At noon, I'll write your initials on a card and put it on a windshield. How are you today?
Great. Great. How are you?
Very good. Water?
I still need to apologize.
For what?
The other day. I invaded your privacy.
But those were unforeseeable circumstances.
You seem troubled.
I was. I'm having legal issues with my husband. We're getting divorced. It's ugly. I had just returned from court that morning.
And is it all sorted out now?
It will be soon. I think it's in his hands, unfortunately.
You mean legally?
Yes. Divorce is complicated in this country.
It's pretty complicated in all countries.
So the drive will be more than an hour. By the time we get there, we'll know everything important about each other.
Okay.
I have children.
I assumed. Me too.
You assumed?
Well, maybe not assumed. I assumed it was possible.
Oh, I thought you meant you saw something in my hips. You know, the way people can see from the way a woman walks.
Oh, I'm not that clever.
Well, they're teenagers now. They live with me.
What are their names?
Rania. She's 14. Mustafa. He's 15. I'm trying to prevent him from becoming an asshole like his father. Any advice?
Does he tell you anything?
Did you tell your mother anything?
Get him alone somewhere. Something like camping.
I can't take my son camping. We don't go camping here. We don't live in Maine. How many kids do you have?
One. A daughter. Kit. She's 21.
Does she tell you anything?
She does.
but I'm not sure...
About what?
Whether I'm helping.
Does she call you sometimes with no particular agenda?
Yeah.
Then you're good.
What do you think our kids would make of this?
How do you mean, you and me? The big culture clash?
I guess so.
Please, we are separated by the thinnest filament.
Well, that's the way I think.
That's the way it is.
Thank you. Strange in a beach house.
Everyone wants to be somewhere else. It's horrible, isn't it? My brother buys paintings wherever he goes. He has the worst taste. Time to swim.
Time to swim?
We're going swimming. You'll borrow my brother's suit. You ready?
I'm ready.
You go in, I'll follow. I didn't mean to scare you.
Sorry.
I have to get under. Neighbors. I must warn you, though, I'm dressed like you. So if someone sees a snorkeling, they'll think it's two men. Just two backs uncovered wearing men's trunks. You understand? Take a deep breath, and then let it out slowly.
Thank you.
It's been a long time.
Yeah. Same here.
How long?
I don't know.
Me neither. I can hardly remember.
I have a story. I've been thinking about it since we spoke about your son.
Please, tell me.
My father and I went camping a few times.
Camping again?
No, it's not about camping. I was 11 or 12. And this one time he brought me up to New Hampshire. It was cold, because it had snowed the week before, and we drove into this national park. And we parked, and we walked deep into the woods for 4 hours at least. And the sun was already falling, so we stopped. No sign of any civilization in any direction. I thought he had a plan. You know, but he acted like he had just figured out the math of it all, that we weren't going to get back before dark, and that the night would freeze us solid. Not to mention the prospect of wolves, bears.
Wolves and bears.
So he asked me, what should we do, son? And I realized this was some kind of a test. So I thought of all the Boy Scout stuff I know, and I said, build a shelter? So we got started, and we took turns chopping and tying. We set it up there, perfectly respectable A-frame. We collected fronds from the pine trees and lined the bottom with them. And he says, Alan, what do we need now? And I knew. We needed a needle and thread. Or duct tape.
For what?
To make a sleeping bag out of our clothes. We cut up our jackets and we taped them together and made a big, wide sleeping bag, and we slept there in our long underwear.
And you shared the sleeping bag?
We did. And I'm going to say that when we were all settled in there, it was really warm.
And you didn't have a fire?
No fire, just each other.
And in the morning?
We taped our jackets back together and went home.
Good.
Hey, Kit. I'm writing to tell you that I'm postponing my return to the United States, and I don't know for how long. The deal I was working on here in Jeddah didn't happen. A competitor from China offered the same technology a lot faster, and at half the price. I shouldn't have been surprised, but there I was. Surprised. So, Kit, the money part of our lives is not solved just yet, but I am working on it. I've taken a new job here, which pays pretty well, and it should be enough even to get you back into school next semester. Keep believing, Kit, as I believe in you. You're strong and young, and you have time. I'm not so young, but I have to tell you, there's a force in my life now that makes me feel strong again. And I feel there's time. There must be time.